everyone. So, last night, on my birthday, I posted a nearly 10-year-old video. It was a lip dub that I did for the song "Wasn't Me" by Shaggy. And the internet is ablaze talking about it. I'm being cheeky, obviously, by saying that. But Dave Portnoy, the man in charge, quote tweeted it. A lot of people at Barstool were messaging me about it. And in my unending quest to fill myself up with as much embarrassment as possible, we're going to have a little bit of fun today, and we're going to watch this video together. I'm going to break down some of the key moments as if it's, you know, some amazing work of art here, which it obviously is not. This one, I have not watched this thing in its entirety in a long time. Other pieces of content that I've done, I can watch any one of my Tiger videos. This one's a bit tough. Let's jump into this. I'll break it down. We can laugh together. We can cringe together. And we can go from there. All right, let's do it. This video, as of the time of this recording, has 280,000 views on Twitter. Ooh, okay. All right. Did not expect that. Let's do it.
Yo, man.
Yo.
Open up, man.
What do you want, man?
My girl just caught me.
You made her catch you?
I don't know how I let this happen.
With who?
The girl next door, you know? I don't know what to do.
Say it wasn't you.
All right.
I think those are my mother's sunglasses. But I could be wrong. It's either my mom's or my dad's. Yeah, I'm pretty sure those are mom's. We're 18 seconds in, so let's keep going.
Honey came in and she got me red-handed, creepy with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom door. How could I forget that I had given her an extra fee? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me.
This is a rough song to do a lip dub to, because Shaggy's lyrics are tough to keep up with. Now, I want to see how well I do. I mean, it's a little bit like Sean Paul. It's not as bad as Sean Paul. But, you know, Shaggy has the accent. I know, talks a lot of this. So we'll see if I can keep up here.
Oh, you think I do my access to your villa? Just a son of weakness, all of your clean on your pillar. You better watch your back before she turn into a killer. Just review the situation that you call the pinna. To be a true player, you have to know how to play. If she say a night, convince her say a day. Never admit to a word where she say. And if she claim her, you tell her, baby, no way.
But she caught me on the counter.
Wasn't me.
Saw me banging on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on camera.
Wasn't me.
You know, I think that... I was a junior in high school, right? So I'm not going to act like I was any sort of connoisseur when it came to comedy. But I am a firm believer that you do anything to make people laugh. I think probably at the time, the world did not need to see me on the toilet.
You saw the marks on my shoulder.
Wasn't me.
Heard the words that I told her.
Wasn't me.
Heard the screams getting louder.
Wasn't me.
She stayed until it was over. Honey came in and she got me
Got to pause. I just noticed this. That's a swimsuit, which is not surprising that I'm wearing. I mean, it's Florida, so, you know, you're not going to wear a button-up three-piece. But at the same time, I'm pretty sure that's a swimsuit with specifically photos of Homer Simpson on it. So even as a junior in high school, I had a questionable fashion sense. Let's move on.
And it's creepy with the girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom door. I had tried to keep her from what she was about to see. Why should she believe me when I told her it wasn't me?
I gotta say, Lance and Catholic Tennis is getting a huge bump today, I feel like. I don't know what their merch sales are gonna be like, but yeah, it's coincidental. But, you know, I was a Lancet Catholic tennis player. So, yeah, insert this clip from Money Shots.
I didn't know you were a tennis guy.
as a former first team All-State tennis player.
Oh, there you go.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah, I know, right? Yeah, it's a huge deal.
Make sure you say that you really not a right for Vix. I never used to see you make the jigger low flex. As somebody else in favor, you in the complex. Seeing is believing, so you better change your specs. You know she have to bring a whole lot of things up from the past. All the little evidence, you better know for mass. Quick for your hands, sir, no off it up. But if she back a gun, you know you better run fast.
But she caught me on the counter.
Wasn't me.
Saw me banging on the sofa.
Wasn't me.
I even had her in the shower.
Wasn't me.
She even caught me on camera.
Wasn't me.
She saw the marks on my shoulder.
Wasn't me.
Heard the words that I told her.
Wasn't me.
Heard the screams getting louder.
Wasn't me.
She stayed until it was over.
You know, in fairness here, I think I do a better job of keeping up with the lyrics than I thought I would. I think with my other lip dubs, the one I did for Classic and the one I did for Shake, those are pretty easy songs to keep up with. They're catchy, you know, kind of, you know, pop songs. And this was a pop song, too. I'm pretty sure it was a big hit. But, you know, they're a relatively simplistic lyrics. Now, ooh, pretty baby, this world might have gone crazy. You know, good, great songs, easy lyrics to keep up with. This one's tougher. So I'm actually, even when I'm not completely 100% in sync with the lyrics, I feel like I'm kind of selling it here. Interesting stuff.
Honey came in and she called me red-handed, creepy with a girl next door. Picture this, we were both butt naked, banging on the bathroom floor. How could I forget that I had given her an extra key? All this time she was standing there, she never took her eyes off me. Wanna tell
at the Roxbury. That's right, it was VideoStar. There was this app on the iPad that essentially allowed you to cut together. I mean, it was similar to iMovie, but it essentially allowed you to cut together clips where you could sync yourself with a music video. You know, there's cringe to that, obviously. I think one of the best qualities a person could have is just the ability to be able to laugh at themselves and be able to laugh at their past and laugh at mistakes. I mean, this wasn't a mistake, but, you know, I mean, I was 17. And to be able to, cringe together and laugh together, I think is a very unique quality. I think that's what makes some of the best Barstool people who they are. At the same time, I'm proud of that. And you know what I'm proud of? I'm proud of the fact that some random teenager made a video 10 years ago, and 10 years later, Dave Portnoy's quote tweeting it. That's interesting. That's unique to me. So, I appreciate everybody watching. You go ahead, like, subscribe, spread the word here. I hope this was enjoyable for all of you. I found it funny. Talk to y'all real soon. We'll have some interesting stuff in the works. Peace and happiness.